있죠. Please be seated.
Le président, veuillez vous asseoir.
The court is now in session.
L'audience est ouverte.
And as we scheduled and informed the parties yesterday,
comme annoncé
today
hier
the chamber
aux parties,
will continue
aujourd'hui,
the document
la
hearing.
Continuera.
Mrs. Sakaguchi, could report the attendance of
Madame
the
Sakaguchi,
parties to
pourriez-vous
discuss
faire rapport sur la présence des parties?
Sakaguchi, Mr. President, for today's proceeding, all parties are present
aujourd'hui,
except the accused
in Sari,
who is present in the holding cell
lequel
downstairs
se trouve dans la
due
cellule
to
temporaire
his health
reason. Pour raison de santé.
The accused, Nunchi and Kyosempong, are absent due to health reasons and they are being treated at the Kumaiso with Francis
ils
Hospital.
Des soins à
the two accused
de
submitted their waiver
ont
for
déposé
this document
leur document
hearing, that is
de renonciation pour cette audience. Document
258/2
et 223/4.
President, thank you.
Le président, merci.
The chamber already ruled yesterday regarding
hier,
the absence of the accused Nunchi and Kyosempong,
des accusés Nunchi et Kyosempong,
who have health issues and are being
pour
treated at the hospital.
Ces accusés
and they
sont soignés
submitted
à l'hôpital. Ils ont
to
remis un document de renonciation
document hearing
concernant l'audience relative au document.
So we can proceed with the document hearing in
l'audience
their absence.
Peut donc se poursuivre en leur absence.
We would like now once again give the floor to the
la
prosecutor
va être redonnée à l'accusation
to present their key
qui pourra présenter ses principaux documents sur les structures militaires
you may proceed.
Du régime Khmer Rouge.
Thank you,
le co-procureur international.
Mr. President,
merci,
good morning
Monsieur
to all.
Le Président, bonjour à tous.
I would like to turn now to some documents from the period of June to December 1976. This is a period for which there are a number, significant number of surviving minutes of meetings between Son Sen and
de
the division secretaries
et les secrétaires de division,
that show the detailed
qui ont
reporting by the divisions,
on voit que les divisions
as well as the communication and implementation of party policies and lines by the military. The first is document E3/814, which is the minutes of a meeting of all division committees
de tous les
held on the 1st
de
of June, 1976. This meeting primarily concerned agricultural production,
sur la production
and it records the communication of the party line or plan on agricultural production
to
the center military divisions. Item 3 of the agenda for the meeting is, quote,
concerne,
a number of specific discussions related to the offensive to achieve 3 tons per hectare in the strategy of 100% self-support and 30% support of Ankar. End of quote.
30% de soutien pour l'Ankar.
And in the report of Brother
dans
89,
le rapport du frère 89
on the second page
à la deuxième
in
page,
paragraph 2b,
paragraph 2b,
which is titled Nation Building,
édification
Son
pays,
Sen instructed the divisions
Son
as follows.
Donne les instructions suivantes aux divisions.
Quote, Je cite, our task is to increase production to 3 tons per hectare and to expand dike systems by 30%.
Et élargir de 30% les systèmes de digues.
The Great Leap movement is strong
le
in the countryside already,
est puissant déjà and the movement dans les campagnes, to make canals, the movement to build dikes, pour, all these are very digues, strong. Tout cela est très puissant.
More detailed plans for
des
rice production were provided by Sansen to the division secretaries in a meeting held on the 18th of August 1976, which meeting is recorded in document
E3/797.
That meeting specified the amount of land to be cultivated each year
de terre à cultiver
and the goal
chaque année,
of earning $4.8 million in capital
4 millions
from rice yields
de capital
over a four-year
period. De riz sur une de ans.
The next document from this period is
période,
document
E3/790.
That's E3/790, which is the decisions of a party committee conference of all divisions that was held from the 10th to 14th of July 1976. This was the second such conference of division committees.
Des de division de ce type.
And the document refers to the first conference as having taken place in April 1976. And the document that resulted from this July 1976 conference
de cette conférence de juillet
is divided into a number of sections that discuss in detail the following duties
en détail
of the RAK.
Les missions suivantes de l'ARK.
First, the duty to continue
la tâche
the socialist revolution.
À poursuivre la révolution socialiste.
Second section of the document,
deuxième section du document
is titled The Duty to Defend the nation and build a revolutionary army to become a party's radical proletariat class dictatorship apparatus. The third section is titled The Duty to Launch a Storming Attack in Constructing Socialism, especially a storming attack in production of 3 tons per hectare. Fourth is duty to build the party, and fifth is duty to resist and eradicate all enemies' devastating intelligence infiltration.
À l'infiltration des ennemis et l'éradication.
In section 2 of this document that discusses the duty to defend the nation,
défense de la nation,
and this is at Khmer ERN 00441999 through 44-2000, English 00714788 through 714789, and French 00752245. In this part of the document, there is a list of 5 measures that were decided. The first is, quote, must pay special attention to the acts of enemy infiltration within our revolutionary army and ranks, end of quote. And the fourth measure listed is, quote, must grasp hold biographies of cadres and combatants strictly by starting to examine at their birthplaces and completely screening all disastrous elements against the revolution from the revolutionary ranks in order to make our army a proletariat class apparatus loyal to the party, socialist revolution lines, construction of socialism, and party's national defense radically. End of quote. Section 4 of the decisions from the July 1976 Division Conference states in paragraph 1, titled Political Ideology,
idéologie politique.
And this may be found at Khmer, page 00442011, English 00714793, and French 00075225151, which reads as follows, quote, in the next 3 months, must educate and disseminate the statutes of the Communist Party of Kampuchea widely, and also must educate and disseminate widely the decisions made in this second division conference among the Party, Communist Youth League of Kampuchea, and male and female combatants of the Revolutionary Army, end of quote. And in regards to biographies,
concernant les biographies,
this document further instructs
ce document donne de nouvelles instructions.
In paragraph 2A.2 of section 4,
de la section 4,
quote,
je vais citer,
must grasp hold the biography of all old party members by assigning certain people to follow up the biography at the base.
De end of quote. Ses biographies jusqu'aux bases.
The last quote from this document I would like to present is paragraph 2E.2 of section 4,
de la section 4,
which is at Khmer page 00442014, English 00714795, and French 00075225353. And this paragraph includes the following statement, quote, it is necessary to have a signed study of the party's documents every month,
que chaque mois les documents du parti soient étudiés,
with specific reference made to documents from the Revolutionary Flag or Revolutionary Youth magazines.
Et de la jeunesse révolutionnaire.
Mr. President, the decisions of the July 1976
Divisions
Conference are referenced in the next document I would like to present, which is E3/795, which is the minutes of a meeting of the secretaries and deputy secretaries of the brigades and regiments that was held on the 2nd of August 1976. In this meeting, each of the divisions and independent regiments reports to Son Sen, Brother 89, on their completion of education or study sessions, to instruct the cadres both on the party statutes and on the decisions from the division conference that had taken place the prior month. At the end of this meeting, in section 3.1 of his concluding remarks, Son Sen emphasizes the importance of continuing such political education on the party lines, stating, and I quote, we must continue teaching the statute and the decision of the brigade conference further. There must be a plan once a month to study statute documents, brigade conference decisions, and various instructions of the general staff. We must pay attention on how to organize class for cadres and male and female combatants to study the Revolutionary Flag Journal, Revolutionary Youth Journal, and revolutionary newspaper continuously.
Les journaux révolutionnaires de façon continue.
The next document I would like to present is E3/798, which is the minutes of a meeting of the division and regiment secretaries and deputy secretaries that was held on the 30th of August 1976. And at this meeting, on the first page of the minutes, Son Sen, or Brother 89, reported on, quote, enemy situations in the grassroots and in troop units or organizations. He describes the arrest of 100 persons who had engaged in unrest on the border of Candlestung District and Sector 33, and the arrest of 60 persons in Sector 25, whose conduct he describes as follows. Quote, they raised a white banner with the slogans, long live Buddhism, long live the White Khmer Front of liberation from rice by the can. They were getting ready for major unrest on 20 August. End of quote. Son Sen states in this part of the meeting that there was a, quote, nexus between this situation and our army. And he indicates that some of the arrested people said in their responses that their leader was Chakri, a reference to the former secretary of Division 170, Chan Chakri, who had been arrested earlier that year. The minutes record five measures proposed by Son Sen in response to this situation, which may be seen at Khmer page 00052380 through 52381, English 00183966, French 00381696 through 97. And the first measure proposed by Son Sen was, quote, give additional education about the spirit of vigilance, do not allow pacifism, end of quote. The third measure was, quote, divisions are to examine and keep track of no good elements, organize for them to be administered separately. Later in this same meeting, in his concluding remarks, which can be seen at Khmer 00052382, English 00183968, French 00386199, Son Sen states, quote, the enemy would like to take the opportunity to gather up no good elements, the status and rank conscious, those whose families we have swept out, those whom we have removed from their positions, and those who have not internalized the revolutionary movement and can't keep up with the rest, and at the same time, the new people who don't yet understand things, whom we are putting in difficulty and temporarily lack food,
end of quote.
Continuing a few paragraphs later, proposed measure 2B states, it is imperative to conduct further purges of no good elements. It is imperative to be absolute.
D'être absolu.
Next document is E3/1133. That's E3/1133. This is an example of the detailed reports regularly provided by divisions, including matters relating to arrests and interrogations of enemies. It is a September 1, 1976 report from Division 502 Secretary Sue Met, which describes in detail the arrests of two soldiers who had stolen chickens, rice, and weapons, and reports on their confessions, which identified other enemies in their network who were subsequently arrested. Document E3/813 is the minutes of a meeting between Sansen and Division 164 that was held on the 9th of September 1976. In this meeting, Division 164 provided a detailed report on the enemy situation in its area, including the capture of a small boat with five Thai and one Khmer person at Koh Rong Samlem Island. In response to this incident, Sansen proposed the following measure in section 4.1 of the minutes.
De ce procès verbal.
Quote, would like to ask the sea unit to be more vigilant. Please send the group of boats that came in Koh Rong Samlem to Angkar for interrogation. The report from Division 164 at the same meeting also included the following statement at the end of Section 3 of the minutes. Quote, mostly the civilians are good, but there are bad movements in the military. Recently, one soldier lieutenant of the former regime was discovered and arrested. End of quote. On that same day, 9 September 1976, Sansen also participated in a meeting with Division 703 Secretary Pin,
S-21
Chairman Deutsch, and S-71 Chairman Palm, which was recorded in document E3/811. This meeting concerned leaflets criticizing the regime that had been found near Wat Botum in Phnom Penh 2 days earlier. In this meeting, S-21 Chairman Deutsch notes that cadres from Division 170, Chakri's division, had been arrested in relation to a prior incident involving similar leaflets. Sansen identifies two networks of enemies that could be responsible. Quote, links connected to Division 170 or, quote, 703s coming from Sector
25.
The measures decided at this meeting and recorded at the end of the minutes are noteworthy. I quote, in terms of organizational problems, comrades Pong and Kami must recognize their heavy duties and go all out in doing constant political and ideological education. They must firmly grasp biographies.
End quote.
In relation to Division 703, Chairman Pin was directed to, quote, re-examine his unit of organization. And the last measures recorded in the minutes are as follows, quote, as for security, I suggest that it increase its surveillance of enemy situations.
D'augmenter la surveillance des
situations. I suggest Comrade Pong liaise with the various ministries.
Une liaison avec les différents ministres.
The 170s should be rounded
les
up
éléments de 170
in one place.
Doivent être rassemblés en un seul endroit. Fin de citation.
One week later, on the 16th of September 1976, a meeting was held between Son Sen, Deutsch, Division 170 Secretary Sock, and Division 290 Secretary
Tal,
which is recorded in document E3/822. That's E3/822. This meeting discussed the recent arrest of Sector 24 Secretary Chouk, who had been implicated by
Chakri.
The minutes expressly refer to a, quote, plan that Ankar had sent out, pursuant to which, quote, all Chakri connections have to be arrested. The meeting thus agreed on the arrest of four cadres from Division 290, 29 cadres from Division 170, whose names are recorded in the document, and the wife and niece of former Division Secretary Chakri. The minutes also note that in a meeting held the previous day, the arrest of 11 additional people from Division 170 had been decided.
On avait décidé de l'arrestation d'un certain nombre d'autres personnes au sein de la division 170.
Document E3/800 is the next I will present. E3/800. It is the minutes of a meeting of the division and independent regiment secretaries and deputy secretaries that was also held on the evening of 16 September 1976. In paragraph 3 of the concluding remarks by Brother 89, titled Examination of Our Army, Son Sen draws attention to the fact that the army includes no good elements, deserters, and some 17 April people from Phnom Penh, and he proposes the following measure, quote, must keep a trace and have a good and thorough grasp of the biographies of the army, especially of those who have just been included by beating the drum after the day on which the whole country was liberated. End of quote.
Le jour où le pays en entier a été libéré.
Another good example of the structured and detailed reporting by division secretaries at joint meetings with Son Sen is document E3/810. That is E3/810. The minutes of a division secretaries meeting held on the 19th of September 1976. In these minutes, it can be seen how each of the divisions and independent regiments reported on the situations in their organizations, covering each of the following subjects in order. First, the enemy situation. Second, the food production situation, followed by the health situation, the food supply situation, and concluding with the party situation. The reports in this document show serious limitations in food supplies and significant health problems in the military. Division 170 Secretary Sock reported, quote, 40% of the brothers and sisters are sick with swelling, diarrhea, and malaria. 10 have died this month. Division 310 Secretary Nguyen reported,
lui,
quote,
fait le rapport suivant. Je sais,
2,600 brothers and sisters are sick,
sont malades,
of whom 400 are seriously ill and cannot work.
Malades et ne peuvent pas travailler.
He also reported, quote, all food supplies will have been eaten during this September.
Écoulé toutes nos provisions alimentaires.
Division 450 Secretary Nguyen reports,
Sun,
quote,
lui fait le rapport suivant.
There are 300 people sick at the division hospital,
l'hôpital de la division,
including those at the regiments. There are 1,000 sick.
Au total, si l'on inclut les
continuing on,
de la
during September, all food supplies have been drawn from
nous
General Staff Logistics.
There are no food supplies
of our own.
Nous n'avons pas,
end of quote.
Nous n'avons pas nos provisions à nous. Nous n'avons pas nos propres provisions. Fin de citation.
The documents E3/1024 and E3/1101. Let me repeat the two documents. E3/1024 and E3/1101. Are examples of written instructions or orders communicated by Sansen by telegram to divisions under the command of the center. These two documents are largely identical telegrams that were sent out by Sansen under his alias Q on the same day, the 23rd of September 1976. One of the telegrams going to Division 810 Secretary Nguyen and the other going to Division 920 Secretary Chin. The instructions sent by Sansen to these two divisions concerned revisionist enemies, in particular Vietnamese who were identified as the Sevens or Group Seven, who were, quote, conducting liaison activities in order to go undercover and bore from within our army and grassroots, and who were encouraging the people to, quote, oppose cooperatives and oppose our line of socialist
revolution.
In these telegrams, Sansen instructs, quote, it is imperative to maintain surveillance of any elements who have had contact with the Sevens or tendencies to prefer the Sevens, to ensure they do not hold leadership positions in the army at any level whatsoever. For such individuals, Sansen further orders divisions 801 and 920 to, quote, absolutely not allow them to bore from within among either cadres or combatants, and in particular absolutely not to allow them to have any contact whatsoever with the divisions along the border, end of quote. Document E3/801 is the minutes of a 30 September 1976 meeting of the divisions and the logistics office of the General Staff, also referred to as Office 62. For this document, I would refer the chamber to the discussion of arrests, including S21, that can be found in the first section of the minutes, where all divisions reported on the enemy situation in their units. For example, Division 310 reports on ill-disciplined elements who had not changed after repeated re-education and sought anchors' advice on those individuals. Division 170 reported that a person had been, quote, arrested and sent to S21 on the 24th of September.
L'unité 170.
Document E3 /820. E3/820 is a 1 October 1976 report regarding Division 170 that was written by witness Un Ren while on assignment at the General Staff Office. Division 170, as noted in prior documents, is the division that had been commanded by Chakri until his arrest earlier that year. In Section 1 of Ren's report, which consists of a review of the past month's work of the division, paragraph E states as follows, quote, the party's discipline has been implemented in accordance with the party's decision. This includes the removal of the cadres who have had political affiliation. Section 3 of this report describes a criticism and self-criticism meeting in which Division Secretary Sok is criticized for failing to fully grasp biographies, especially, quote, the contemptible Chakri's associates. And near the end of this report, there is a description of various cadres from the division who were, quote, sent to the division education site. Document E3/1225, that's E3/1225, is a 6 October 1976 telegram that was sent from DIM, the Deputy Secretary of Division 164. It is addressed to Brother Mutt, the Division Secretary, and CC'd or copied to Brother Nguyen and Brother Q. Paragraph 3 of that telegram discusses the use of children to search for bandits and concludes, quote, if we fail to meet those bandits, at least we will meet contemptible traitors burrowing within the village who would come to contact those bandits, end quote. I would now like to turn to document E3/13, which is a document I'd like to cover in some detail.
C'est un document dont j'aimerais longuement parler.
This document is the minutes of a 9 October 1976 meeting of the secretaries and deputy secretaries of the divisions and independent regiments. Pursuant to the agenda for that meeting, the first item discussed was the upcoming ceremony for the party anniversary that was to take place on the 11th of October. In the minutes, note that the commemoration of the party anniversary, whose date was actually the 30th of September, had been delayed that year because, quote, the organization has been busy, end of quote. And in order to understand the context of the delay in the party anniversary celebration that year, I would like to step back for a moment and present two other documents recording events that took place in the weeks leading up to the party anniversary. The first of those documents is D288/6.5/2.22. Let me repeat, D288/6.5/2.22. which is the S21 confession file of Sector 24 Secretary Chouk, who had been arrested on the 31st of August 1976, and whose interrogation at S21 was ongoing in the month of September 1976. That file at Khmer 00038515 contains a 19 September 1976 document whose cover page is titled First Step of Eight's Confession and Plans to Smash Brother Number One and Brother Number Two while traveling during a party assembly, the party anniversary, or other celebrations during 1976. And the document I would like to focus on is a 26 September 1976 report written by Deutsch, which is addressed to respected brother. And this report by Deutsch can be found at Khmer pages 00038660 through 38662, English pages 00831531 through 33. The first paragraph of Deutsch's report stated that, quote, Brother Fo did act as an active mastermind and orchestrator of the plot to get rid of Brother One, Brother Two, yourself, and some other leaders with intellectual background. End of quote. The second background document to help understand the events of this period is E3/192. On the 27th of September 1976, following the date of the document I just presented in which Deutsch reported to his superior on a purported assassination plan, a statement was issued by Khieu Samphan announcing that Pol Pot, Premier of Democratic Kampuchea, was taking temporary leave from his task in order to take care of his health. It also announces that Nguyen Chea has been appointed to temporarily replace Pol Pot as acting premier, effective from the 27th of September 1976. I present these two documents in order to understand the context of the time period during which the party anniversary ceremony was delayed from the 30th of September to the 11th of October 1976. Returning now to E3/13, the minutes of the 9th October 1976 Division Secretaries meeting, and in the middle of these minutes, beginning at Khmer 00052405, English 00183984, and French 00334974. Son Sen provides a detailed report to the division leaders on, quote, a number of traitors in the party whom we have been able to arrest, and on plans that were learned through their responses to interrogations. And I will now read a number of excerpts from this part of Son Sen's report. Quote, first, we arrested the traitorous links in Division 170. You must take note with regard to this problem to maintain secrecy and not to disseminate to the lower levels. Continuing a few paragraphs below, quote, previously, there were incidents of guns being fired near the Fine Arts School and leaflets being thrown near the palace. Then, in early April 1976, they threw grenades and threw leaflets again. We felt these were enemy activities. Those implicated in the answers of those we were able to arrest went right up to Chakri.
De ceux qui avaient été arrêtés, nous ont permis de remonter jusqu'à
and I would note here that the initial person arrested following the grenade explosion at the Royal Palace that is described here was a cadre named
Yim Sambat.
His S21 file document D288/6.5/2.14. Let me repeat, D288/6.5/2.14 includes a report by Deutsch dated the 6th of August 1976. This report, which can be found at Khmer 0024-5206-24-5211, English 00028-40-03-08, and French 00808-07-59-64. This is a report written by Deutsch on August 6, 1976, that describes in detail the history of arrests and confessions that eventually led to the arrest of Division 170 Secretary Chakri. It also, in this document, Deutsch forwarded to his superiors letters that had been found in Chakri's room after his arrest on the 20th of May, 1976.
Après son arrestation le 20 mai 76.
And the information in this report is consistent with what is reported by Son Sen to the division secretaries at the 9th of October 1976 meeting. And returning again to the minutes of that meeting, E3/13,
Son Sen
provides a report regarding the arrest of Chakri, which continues as follows at Khmer page 00052405 through 52406, English page 00183985, French page 00334975, and in this part of the minutes, it is Son Sen's statements are recorded as follows, quote, these are Son Sen's statements regarding describing the arrest of Chakri. Quote, upon arrest, he responded clearly that he was a Sri link and that his boss was Chuk, the secretary of Sector 24. We arrested Chuk, and he responded that he had contacts with a Vietnamese to make arrangements to attack our party's leading apparatus. They would attack from the inside while Vietnam attacked from the outside. The UN was named Bai Ma. Chuk's responses ultimately implicated Ya. We arrested Ya, and he responded that he had been a traitor since 1962, along with somebody else named Khao Mia. This network had created a new party back in 1962 and was linked with Oral and Kumsa. We could then see clearly what had been going on with the unrest in Kokang and the problem of contradictions between Sector 25 and Sector 33. We have basically smashed the leadership links, but their henchmen still exist.
Les chefs, mais leurs subordonnés existent toujours. Fin de citation.
On the next page of this document, at the bottom of Khmer 52407, Son Sen makes a statement regarding the forced movement of the Cambodian population from urban areas.
Sur les transferts forcés,
and I quote,
de population des centres urbains.
If we had left the people in and not evacuated them from cities and towns,
nous n'avions pas évacué des villes,
we would not have the peace and quiet we enjoy today. If we had not been absolute about making cooperatives,
si nous
not been absolute about making socialism,
si
we would not be victorious.
Du socialisme, nous n'aurions pas eu la victoire.
And it is revealing in these minutes to look at the remarks of the division and regiment secretaries that followed Son Sen's announcement of the arrests of Chuk and Ya. Starting on Khmer page 00052408, English 00183987, French 00334978. In this part of the minutes, Division 170 Secretary Sok, after this announcement, noted, quote, Division 170 has purged 70 no-goods and is keeping them in one place. Division 290 Secretary Tal reports, quote, company cadre manifested opposition activities by not disseminating the party line within the unit of organization or not distributing the banner's magazine. On the next page of this document, Khmer 52409, Division 703 Secretary
Pin
states, ERN is 00052409. And at this part of the minutes, Division 703 Secretary Pin states, quote, as regards the problem of traitors and the party's measures, I agree completely. The reason for the treason is these guys' contradictions about status and rank. Even though we've arrested their bosses, they are continuing with their activities. As for the problem of a grasp on the unit of organization, after repeated study and purges, it is possible to guarantee the defense of the party. Division 450 Secretary Sun reports,
ensuite,
quote, the no-good elements have been rounded up, but not yet entirely purged. I have a grasp on those who are liberal to a certain degree.
Connais ceux qui ont des tendances libérales.
And on the next page, Khmer
00052410,
Division 310 Secretary Hun makes the following statement.
Lui dit, quote, la chose suivante.
In the past, the party
passé,
gave repeated education about events taking place inside the party and inside leading units of organization about the enemies boring from within.
À propos des ennemis qui
s'enfuissaient. However, I never previously imagined that there was treason at such an important level as in the information that the organization has gotten today. Continuing later, quote, a number of cadre's biographies are not yet clearly grasped, and it's not known whether they are clean, reliable, and enthusiastic or not clean. There is the phenomenon of those who are concealing their biographies all the way up to the company cadre level, those who originally were white Khmer or who have lived with the Vietnamese. In total, we have got 36 no goods. End of quote. On the next page, Khmer 00052411, Division 502 Secretary Soumet comments as follows, quote, after the party revealed the upper traitorous links belonging to American imperialism and the revisionists, I was happy and had more faith in the party. Continuing later, with regard to this problem, it can be stipulated that the enemies have been basically eliminated, but it is imperative to take further measures to prevent this from happening a second, a third, and a fourth, and so on again time. It is imperative to dare absolutely to conduct purges. End of quote. On this same page, Division 164 Secretary Miasmut states, quote, I would like to say about the concern with activities of the traitors within the party that this has been a great victory for our party. This lesson has strengthened another degree the standpoint of revolutionary vigilance. As for the problem of the grasp on the unit of organization, cadre, and combatants, it is not yet firm. No good elements or enemies are still camouflaged and infiltrated in the rank and file. End of quote. And in Son Sen's concluding statements at this meeting held on the 9th of October 1976, he makes the following remarks in section 1, which can be seen commencing at Khmer 00052412 through 52413, English 00183991, French 00334981. At this part of the meeting, Son Sen states, and I quote, those present at the meeting are in unity with the party in considering that the arrest of these traitors is a great victory over the revisionists who were following the secret road and had been infiltrating for more than 10 years already. Continuing a couple of paragraphs below, quote, another lesson results in our realizing that trivial activities attacking the revolution, such as stealing and speaking in hints that attack the revolution, all issue forth from such traitorous links.
Tout cela est le fruit de liens avec ces traîtres.
And the measures set forth in section 3 of Son Sen's concluding statements include the following operational methods, which you may find at Khmer page 00052414. Proposed measures reads, and I quote, it is imperative to purge no good elements absolutely in the sense of an absolute class struggle. The purge is premised on three principles. Category 1,
première
catégorie, the dangerous category. They must be absolutely purged. Category 2, the ordinary liberal category. They must be educated again and again in our education schools. Category
3,
the category of those who have merely been incited by the enemy, merely believed the enemy incitement. As a first step, they should undergo refashioning to get them to no longer believe the enemy.
End of quote.
The next document I would like to turn to is document E3/815. That is E3/815, which is the minutes of a meeting with the division secretaries and deputies that was held on the 18th of October, 1976. At this meeting, Sun Sen makes yet another presentation on the treasonous events in the army and in the base areas, which are attributed to two groups, first the CIA and second the revisionist group led by the Soviet Union and Vietnam. The meeting also agreed on the following measure, which you can see at Khmer page 00095529 through 95530, English 00877017, and French 00062 39 45 through 46. And the measure that is stated in the minutes here reads as follows, quote, with the entire country, let the military staff have discussion with the zones. Wherever the center army is located, we will take measures, especially in the defense of Phnom Penh. One division must prepare one battalion of forces, weapons with ammunition and vehicles to be constantly on standby. This battalion specifically must prepare one company with the objective of defending the radio station, Ankar's location, and the military staff locations. Select people that are clean in terms of politics, ideology, and organization. Arm them with light weapons, AKs, light machine guns, M79s, B40s, B41s. Deploy this force at the city's important target areas and maintain constant radio contact with the military staff. End of quote. Next document is E3/1135. That's E3/1135. Which is another example of a military division report to Sun Sen, which was then forwarded by Sun Sen to other party leaders, in this case to the accused Nguyen Chea. This is a 19 October 1976 report that originates from Division 164 Secretary Mutt
de Mutt, secrétaire de la division 164,
to Brother 89 regarding certain individuals who had disappeared from the Division 164 hospital. And on the left margin of the document, if you would look
gauche,
at the left margin at the document, there is a handwritten
note
sent the following day from Sun Sen, alias Q, to Bong Nguyen, making a request for approval to search for two of the individuals listed in Mia Smut's
report.
Document E3/1151. E3/1151 is an example of a telegram sent from Son Sen to Division 164 Secretary Mutt, communicating approval for measures that had been proposed.
Pour les mesures proposées.
And this is a telegram from Brother 89 to Comrade Mutt, dated 4 November 1976, which states in the upper left-hand corner, instructions for 164.
Instruction à l'attention de 164.
And in the first sentence of the telegram, it identifies the specific telegram from Division 164 Secretary Mutt, to which it was responding. In paragraph 3, Son Sen conveys approval for the measures that had been proposed by Mutt, and then lists further measures relating to the issue of vessels entering Cambodian waters.
Des bateaux qui pénètrent, qui entrent dans les eaux
documents E3/1585, that's E3/1585, is the attendance list for the first General Staff study session that began on the 20th of October 1976. And documents E3/847 and E3/1142 are attendance records for the second General Staff study session that commenced on the 23rd of November 1976. I will not discuss these documents further today other than to note that they provide a useful record for the Chamber by which to identify the various divisions and independent regiments and the individuals who serve on the division, regiment, and battalion committees that formed the RAK in this time period. The next document I would like to discuss is document E3/1164. It's E3/1164. This is a report dated 25 November 1976 from Division 801 Secretary Roon to Brother 89.
De la division
and
801
at Khmer page 00052327, English 00516711, French 00532754. The report proposes a number of organizational measures relating to enemies who had infiltrated the division, including that, quote, anyone who is suspicious of being an enemy must absolutely be arrested, end of quote, and that temporary arrests should be made of persons implicated in
documents.
At the end of the document, the Division 801 Secretary states, quote, this is a report of Committee 801 regarding enemy activities and measures as stated above, and we request that Uncle make remarks and comments. We look forward to receiving the party's recommendations, end of quote. Document E3/804 is the minutes of a meeting of the secretaries and logistic officers of the divisions and independent regiments that was held on the 15th of December 1976. In a paragraph 2A of the concluding opinions of Brother 89 regarding party work, Son Sen discusses the result of efforts to date to screen biographies of military cadres and notes, quote,
voici ce qu'il relève.
The results of grasping
le
the biographies this time were good,
cette fois-ci a été
but there's still, there are still some comrades who are hiding their histories.
Continuent de dissimuler
be most
leurs
careful about those whose mothers and fathers were purged
ont été
or whose siblings were purged.
Ou dont les frères et sœurs ont été purgés.
And in paragraph 4, regarding military installations,
qui porte sur les installations militaires, Sun Sen donne
quote,
des instructions. Je cite,
must prepare especially for the intervention unit,
en particulier
must
concernant
screen it clean.
Il faut
only when
nettoyer,
the general
la
staff
maîtriser.
Sends orders to the
ce
division
n'est que lorsque
and the division gives the order, can they go out on operations?
Que pourront end of quote. Lancer des opérations.
Sun Sen also discusses in section 3 of these minutes a number of party circulars that had been received in which Ankar communicated decisions that pistols were not to be carried in general and that the use of telephones was to be avoided for secrecy reasons.
Qu'il fallait, pour raison de secret, s'abstenir d'utiliser des téléphones.
An example of how information was reported up the chain of command can also be seen in documents
E3/1079
and E3/1132. The first of these documents, E3/1079, is a report that was sent by Division 801 Secretary Roon to Brother 89 on the 25th of December 1976. The second document, E3/1132, is a report prepared by the general staff, which is titled, quote, overall situation in the country and along the border via telegrams from the 1st to 31st December 1976. And in comparing these two documents, it can be seen that the information that was reported by the Division 801 Secretary in the first document, in paragraphs 2, 3, and 4 of his report, were then taken by the General Staff and included as part of their overall report regarding the situation for that month, which you will see in the section for Division 801 in the General Staff report.
Que l'on retrouve dans le rapport de l'état-major portant
I will
sur
now
la
turn to a few examples
Je
of documents, military documents,
des documents
from
1977.
E3/807 is the minutes of a division secretary's
Procès
meeting that was held on the 1st of March 1977. In section one of these minutes, there is extensive reporting of the ongoing purges in the military. For example, Division 502 Secretary Met reports, quote, it's obvious that a number of elements whom we have previously arrested really are enemy elements. More than 50 no goods have been sent to S21. There can only be reliability if 5 more platoon secretaries are removed.
La fiabilité ne pourrait être assurée que si l'on retire encore 5 pelotons.
Secretary Chin of Division
920,
who himself would be arrested and sent to S21 2 weeks later, reports, quote, those who came to us from the Vietnamese and the children of soldiers, sub-district chiefs, and police were purged and sent to do production in one place, end of quote. And Comrade Yan from Division 450 reports, maybe 600 persons are elements who must be removed. In this same meeting, and I would refer you to Khmer pages 00052306 and also 52308 through 09, English pages 00183951 through 53, and French pages 00032 3925 through 27. Brother 89, San Sen, advises the divisions as follows, quote, after we eliminated the Chuuk and Ya treasonous networks, we discovered another treasonous network which we have basically eliminated. Later, Son Sen continues to provide another detailed history of the purges within the party, and his proposed measure states, quote, mere education is not enough. It is imperative to continue further with absolute purges. Son Sen also instructs at this meeting that the duty of defending the country was now to take precedence over all other duties of the RAK. And at Khmer page 00052310, Son Sen notes the distinction between antagonistic contradictions and internal contradictions, stating, quote, it is imperative to grasp the antagonistic contradictions to the utmost degree. In the past, we have eliminated a lot of important traitorous links, but it is imperative to continue with further revolutionary vigilance, because remnants still remain and new traitors will continue to be born. Internal contradictions require education, whereas antagonistic contradictions require absolute organizational methods. End of quote. Documents E3/1061 and E3/1060 are reports from Division 801 to Brother 89, dated the 24th of March 1977 and the 29th of March 1977, both of which contain handwritten annotations forwarding those reports to Ankara. A section 3 of the 24 March 1977 report, which is document E3/1061, Division 801 Secretary Roon reports on the capture of 7 Vietnamese prisoners at the border and on the results of the interrogation of those prisoners. And in his 29 March 1977 report, document E3/1060, he describes the enemy situation throughout the entire northeast region, including the base. The handwritten annotation in the upper left side of the first page of E3/1060. The handwritten annotation on the first page of that report forwards the document to Ankar and makes reference to Tuol Sleng. And paragraph 5 at the very end of this report sums up the situation in the unit as follows. Quote, we were following the trail of both new and old elements destroying the revolution. Those targets included those going against the revolutionary line and those newly and previously implicated by the enemy.
End quote.
In regards to how division secretaries were informed of persons in their divisions who had been implicated, I would like to now present a few examples of annotations on S21 confessions, which reflect how division secretaries were informed by the center of people implicated. First is document D43/4, Annex 22. We repeat D43/4, Annex 22. And this is a S21 confession of a cadre from Division 502 named Sur Tun alias Mao. And I would like, if we can show on the screen, please, Khmer page 00173999, which is English page 00224628. French 00271447. And there is a handwritten note on the cover page of this confession from Son Sen to Division 801 Secretary Rune, which reads as follows. Dear Comrade Rune, please read this report of Mao and pick out the relevant names of Unit 801. I will help you tomorrow as I'm busy this afternoon. May you keep this confidential. This note, which is in red, is signed by Q and dated the 2nd of June, 1977. Another example is document E3/150. That's E3/150, which is the S21 confession of Division 164, Deputy Secretary Hong Dun alias Dim. And the annotation I would like to present on this confession is at Khmer page 00174375, English 00224085, French 00235668. And if you would look at this annotation,
examinez cette annotation,
it includes the following statement, quote, to brother to be informed about the plan, it is followed.
Concernant le plan, il a été
though some
appliqué.
Are the right people, some others
certains
whom I have known are not.
De bons éléments, mais d'autres que
I will
je connais
invite
ne le
Comrade
sont pas.
Mut
j'invite
to check
le
this together.
Mut à
end
vérifier
of quote.
Cela.
Another example of the coordination between the center and divisions relating to persons implicated in S21 confessions is document D43/4, Annex 99. That is D43/4, Annex 99. And this is another confession of a Division 164 cadre,
Khun Dim. Dim.
And I would refer to the cover page,
je
which is Khmer
00175293,
English 00 82 23 59 59, French 00 28 28 98 72. This page contains a handwritten note dated 10 September 1977, signed by Son Sen under his alias Q. And paragraph 2 of Son Sen's note states, quote, 22 as well as division 164 of Comrade Mutt are mentioned. And in paragraph 3b of the note, quote, contact Comrade Mutt so that he can take measures. We have already basically removed all those on Comrade Mutt's side. And I would also note that at the top of the same page, there is another annotation indicating that a copy of this confession was sent to Brother Nguyen on the 10th of September 1977. In addition to substantive annotations like the ones just presented, there are other S21 confessions that contain more basic annotations, simply recording that a copy of the confession was sent to the relevant division secretary. For example, D43/4-91 is the confession of Chea Sun, a regiment secretary in Division 703, and referring to the top of Khmer page 00174986, there is an annotation that reads, quote, copy for Comrade Pim. Similarly, document D 302.5, that's D302.5, is the S21 confession of a Division 502 cadre Srey Sarun. And underneath the confession title, at Khmer page 00235162, you will see the annotation, quote, one copy sent to Comrade Met, end of quote. Before I conclude, Mr. President, I have a few more documents to present relating to the military structure from the 1977 time period. I have 5 to 10 more minutes. I can either continue now or finish after the break at your discretion.
President, thank you. The time is now appropriate for adjournment. The chamber will adjourn for 20 minutes and we will resume at 5 to 11.